Hello, sweet, beautiful animals. I am live from Santa Barbara, where everything is burning down. It's pretty crazy. I don't say that lightly. It's like a really major fire. It's a pretty major event happening here. And I'll give you guys just a view out the window before we dive into the meditation. So, this is the air quality here. And usually you can see the ocean just that way from this porch here. So it's pretty bad. I woke up this morning feeling my lungs were really hurting and decided it was time to head north. So we're gonna go up to the Bay Area, which a lot of people have started to do. So, wow, when I pulled the Phoenix a couple weeks ago, I had no idea that this was in store, but I'm really grateful. I left this card out for a week and sat with it, and I pulled it the week after I had done the last meditation I did was the cosmic egg, which is for the crown chakra, and so the Phoenix is for the root. And I was sort of sitting with the contrast of that and working on a lot of healing in my own root. And certainly this fire for a lot of people has, myself included, been, shaking up and continuing the purge of stuff that's, around security and safety and being at home and feeling grounded. And it's quite challenging, and it's a beautiful medicine, frankly, to have this during this time. So yeah, I couldn't figure out why. I was just like not feeling like it was time to do the Phoenix meditation yet. And a couple weeks went by, I was still thinking about it, and then everything, started last Monday with the fires. And so today I finally got the hit, like it's the right time now. So we're gonna go in to a little experience with this powerful power animal. And again, if you've watched some of these, and you'll understand that, and if this is new for you, I'll just point it out. The circle on the top of this card represents the animals that are associated with the ether, so animals that are in other dimensional realms that we can't necessarily see at this time with these eyes, and the way that I see Leon laying here, or a bird outside, but that they are really real in an energetic way, and so we get to connect with their medicine just as much as we connect with, the tigers and the doves and the snails and everything else. So, welcome, and without further ado, let's connect with the Phoenix. So go ahead and lower your eyes and start with a couple breaths just to center, and as you're breathing, really bring your awareness, start to come down your spine and feel your breath reaching all the way down to the bottom of your spine. And just see, so have a little check-in of like what's alive there in your body right now. What sensation do you feel when you allow your breath to start to reach down into that low-rooted place in your body? And we dedicate this time with a prayer for everyone who's experiencing turmoil with these fires, and especially for the animals that are on the run right now, and the animals that have lost their lives. And we're going to connect now with the phoenix. So if you're not familiar, the phoenix is this beautiful creature that is a bird that combusts, literally goes up in flames, only to be reborn over and over again. This incredible cycle of rising from the ashes and then allowing the purifying nature of fire to come through again and again and again. And so feel down at the very base of your spine, right where your root is. Feel just this glow of a reddish, even sort of a fuchsia energy. It's the sun, this last week, the sun here with the smoke in the air has appeared fuchsia, and the moon as well. And so calling in that deep red and fuchsia light to our roots right now. Just feel the warmth of that, the power of that, the pleasure of that light coming in and having your awareness, your attention there for a moment. And now inviting in the phoenix specifically to this region of our bodies. So allow yourself to just make contact with this animal totem and feel this large and powerful and other dimensional bird coming and being there at your root, and feel it actually starting to rise up from your root into your second and third chakras and sort of moving its energy up your spine. And as it does, imagine that there are perhaps you can check in, perhaps there are some dead branches or some dry grass or some other sort of bramble that the phoenix is having to, you know, sort of push through to make its ascent up. And so just feel like what, if anything, what is there sort of blocking that path from being clear? And feel into like, and maybe you have a name for what those dry sticks are, or perhaps not. And they can just be sort of felt in an energetic way as well without having to name them. And as you witness what's there, we invite in the fire of the phoenix now. So just welcome in the energetic purification of the phoenix in this way, this medicine that it brings us. By burning away the clutter, burning away what's old and dead and no longer serves us. feeling how it can be this sort of sudden burst of energy, and really it's not too much work to incinerate everything. So, you know, in that brief moment, I bow to you for all that you allowed to be cleared with the help of the Phoenix. And now you can feel in the very base of your spine, the very root of your root, you can feel there is a beautiful nest, and in that nest is a pure white egg. And just as the phoenix rises and burns, it is reborn with new life. And so feel yourself witnessing this little egg. It's actually kind of a large egg. And how beautiful and pearly white it is, and how the light just sort of glows around it. And as you witness this, feel the heartbeat of the phoenix that is inside of this egg, this little baby bird growing, almost ready to hatch, and just tune into its heartbeat for a moment. That continues. In spite of it all, in spite of everything going up in flames, that the heartbeat continues. And just bring a hand to your heart, and perhaps you want to put a hand on your root right now. And just feeling the connection there of your own heart to the heart of the phoenix. And knowing that no matter what is happening in your life right now, in this moment, you are safe in this moment. You are safe, and you can receive this medicine and you are loved.